Hello everyone, Narcissist Pri almost here. I'm using my own voice today with the little voice trick. Hopefully it's not too bad. I'll still be using Sally for longer videos because it takes me a while to get everything I want to say out. Anyway, today I wanted to very briefly talk about the narcissist and decompensation. Yes? Exner too is well on his way. This is something I've seen happen before, and really, when the particular narcissist I was involved with relies solely on the high they get from attention by using someone like me all the time, when that's taken away, their world, as they age, of course, starts to get smaller and smaller, and you have fewer and fewer opportunities to get supply, not to mention other people around them start to catch on. And these days, even though I've been living in a bubble, apparently everyone knows about narcissism now. Yes, I'm still in a long-term care facility, so I'm not really out there talking to people that much. And when I listen to videos, I hear people talking about how everyone calls everyone a narcissist these days, and that makes me really happy. I'm so glad people really are catching on. People aren't getting their lives ruined anymore. But the bad thing about it is it tends to get diluted. So when that happens and everyone's calling everyone else a narcissist, it sort of loses its meaning, if you know what I mean. So anyway, the decompensation, like I said, I've seen it before. I even warned my ex-narc when we were divorcing, this doesn't end well once I'm out of the picture, because I was his primary source of supply and the one unknowingly who got all other people together to give him supply. That's how he used me, all behind my back, of course. And what it looks like is much like a drug addict in withdrawal. And it's periodic, you know. And I'm sure there's moments of absolute dread, as if someone who's going through withdrawal can attest to the desperation, the not knowing if you're going to get your drug again, frantic. And after a while, that sort of tension wears on the human body, especially for a narcissist, because this is not something that will ever go away. It's not something that can be fixed. So imagine a junkie who's in withdrawal for the rest of his life, right? And it's getting harder and harder to get your fix. And that's basically what your decompensation is going to look like. And it started, and I'm sure it's going to get worse. How it manifests physically and socially, I'm not that aware of because I'm super low contact. I know, I shouldn't be contacted at all, but he still has my stuff. And it's not just clothes and stuff like that, it's like family heirlooms that I need to get back. So once I'm out of here, knock on wood, pretty soon, I should put an end to that. But I have this morbid curiosity where I just want to check in every once in a while to tell badly it's going. Hey, you know, I'm human. I want revenge. As I know I'm never going to get, but satisfaction that is. Anyway, that's where things are right now for my ex. And I know it's not going to get better. I've seen it before with my mother. And a lesser narcissist, one that is not so addicted, can find other addictions. But for someone like my ex-narc, I'm pretty sure he wouldn't turn to drugs or alcohol or anything like that. So the psychological manifestation should be interesting. Things such as, you know, mini psychotic breaks, things like that. So if you had any experience with the aging, fading narcissist, please let me know. But that's it for now. I just wanted to update. And I hope everyone is doing well. Take care.